Okay, people, so on the right hand side I've uploaded 4 trace tables for you. So you see, you can download all of them from trace 1 to trace 2, 3 and 4. It's just all past papers. Trace 4 isn't actually a trace table, but it's a part of a program where we can answer those questions. But basically, to also answer those questions is, if you do a trace table, it sort of makes them easier to understand. What I've also uploaded, I uploaded my Excel spreadsheet. So just a blank one, you'll see there's 4 tabs for the 4 trace tables we've given. So I sort of created them already for you, just to make it easier if you've got Excel at home to answer them. So I'm going to start with the first one. So they've given us these columns and then they asked us to do it. If they don't give you the columns, it boils down to that for each variable you need to create the column, and for each condition you create the column and then your display. So please, with this, just stop me every now and again, and if somebody is in Discord and you see somebody asking a question, just let me know so that I stop, for the people that don't have mics. But then, or if you want to, you can send it on WhatsApp for me, the questions, then I know to stop. I have my phone in front of me, so I'll see the WhatsApp messages as they come up if you don't have a mic. Alright, so the whole idea is we must just now follow through this thing. So let's see. Line 1 says number must get a value of 4. So we give number a value of 4. Then they say count must get a value of 1. So you're going to give count a value of 1. To make our life easier, let's just center these things. Okay. Then they say the number of factors gets a value of 0. So we give it a value of 0. Then they say while count is less than or equal to number. So is count less than or equal to number? And 1 is less than 4. So this is true. There we go. If the number modulus count is equal to 0, you'll see this one. So we take our number. Who can remember, what does modulus do again? If we say number modulus count, so if we say number modulus count, what does that do?
Isn't that just mod?
Yes, it's just mod. So what is 4 mod 1? Or what does mod do?
Show the remainder only, I think.
Yes, so what it does the division, but it only shows the remainder. So when we divide 4 by 1, the answer is 4 with 0 remainder. So number modulus count equal to 0, so this is true for the first one. So because this is true, then our number of factors becomes whatever number of factors was plus 1. So number of factors becomes 1. Alright, then the if is done, so then count must become whatever count was plus 1. So count becomes 2. And then the loop goes back. So you'll see with the indentation, this takes us back to the while loop. So we're back at this while. So is count less than or equal to number? Is count less than or equal to number? And that's true. That means we go in. So that means that we're at the if again. So is our number mod count, our number mod count equal to 0? So we'll say 4 divided by 2 is exactly 2 with no remainder. So that the remainder would still be 0. So that's true. That means our number of factors must become whatever it was plus 1. So our number of factors becomes 2. And then our count must increment. So our count becomes 3. Then we check, is count less than or equal to number? Is count less than or equal to number? That's true. Then we take our number and we mod it by count. So the numbers of 4 divided by 3 actually gives us 1,25. So it's not equal. So there is a remainder. There's a remainder of 1, not 0. So this is false. And because this is false, we don't do that. So this doesn't change. But the count is not inside the if. So count must become whatever count was plus 1, so that becomes 4. Then we check again, is count less than or equal to number? And 4 is equal to 4, so that's true. Then we do our if again. If our number mod count is equal to 0. So 4 divided by 4 is 1 with no remainder. So this is true as well. Because this one is true, our number of factors become whatever it was plus 1. So it becomes 3. Our count must increment by 1. And then is count less than or equal to number? So that is false. And because this one is false, our while loop is done. So then we display the number of factors. So we display 3. And that is this is our trace table for the first one. Any questions on this? Okay, so I'm gonna assume everything is fine. And do we have to structure the trace table like so? So the other option you could have gone you could have gone line by line. So first line says number should be 4, next one said count must be 1, next one said number of factors should be 0, then we're checking if that, so that was true, then we're checking for that one was true, and then our number of factors increased, so then that becomes 1. And then our count increased, so that then that became 2. And then we checked again for that, and then that was true again. Then we checked for that one, then that was true. So you could have gone this route as well, where you, and then obviously carry on with this. So you could have gone like line by line. It just, it goes on a bit longer. But this could be, you could have also done that. Just, I think I missed some questions. Okay, we initialize it around then before the loop. If we use display all the number, but so if we display all the number of factors as we went along and not only at the end be penalized, yes, you would be. Can I upload a version that I'm thinking of? Yes, you can do that, Sandir. So yes, if you went and you displayed number of factors the whole time, normally our marks is allocated like these 6 marks, you'll see there's 6 columns, 1 2 3 4 5 6, yeah, so it's a lot of times it's 1 1 1 1 1 1 mark. So if your display, if you displayed 0 1 2 and then 3, you'd have not gotten this mark because you're displaying the wrong stuff. If you did this one, this route, and you kept the 4 the whole time there, and you kept this one 1 until it became 2, and then you kept the 2 as it went along, and if you kept this one 0, you kept that one once. If you did this, it was also sort of okay. It's not ideal, as you can see, it just looks confusing. But if you do this way, sometimes the questions actually, what they do is, you'll get some questions somewhere where they actually have another column here called line. And then you sort of have to do this one, because this happens in line 1, that happens in line 2, that happens in line 3, that is in line 4, that is in line 5, then this happens in line 6, and that's in 7. And then here we're back at line 4 again, and then back at line 5 again. So then you had to say, like, in which line, see, then you use these numbers to indicate which line you're using. So then you'll go this route by doing it this way. Let me maybe finish this one. So then line 5 we checked was true. So then our number of factors increased again, and then our count increased, and then we went back to check again. So then it was still true, this one. But then with this one, when count was 3, this was actually false. So, and when that one was false, this one never increased. So then it just count just increased to 4. Then we checked again and it was true again. And then we checked this one and this one was true. And then we went back and this one increased to 3. And then that one became 5. And then that one became false. And then that one became 3. So then with these numbers, this way where our number of factors increased was line 6, that was line 7, then it went back to line 4, that was line 5, that was line... See, so 6 was skipped here, so that one goes to 7 immediately. And that's again line 4, line 5, line 6, line 7 we did that at, and then this was again line 4, and then we went to line 8 at the end. So if the question wanted you to do line numbers, yours would have looked like this. So it's sort of the same thing, it's just more separated. Like every time, whenever a particular line tells you to do something, you say that line told me to do that. Line number 2 told me to do that. Line number 3 told me to do that, and so forth. So when you get to line 7, told me to do this. And after line 7, because it's in the while loop, you go back to line 4 to first to go check again if you should carry on or not. All the truths meant we must carry on, and only when it was false, our while loop was done. So then it went out of the while loop to do the display, which was not in the while loop. Let's look at this one. So are you talking about the zero basically? So you made the count 0. Sandir, okay, so why did you make count 0? Yeah, try not to make... Wait, why did you make 0? You see again? You didn't make... No, this is the same thing as what I've done. 410. And then 421. No, it's fine, same thing. Count was supposed to be 1. Yeah, no, so it's same thing. No, this is... Well, it's exactly the same as what I'm doing, so it's fine. Yeah, so these are the two ways you could have done it. This one is acceptable in this case because they didn't ask for number. If you added the line, or if they wanted the line, then it would have looked like this, and that's also fine. All good. Give me 3 goods, then I can carry on.
It could.
Say. It's 1.
Good.
2. Okay, we'll take that static as a number 3, that's good. Okay, then we're looking at trace table 2. So trace table 2, one of the competitions will require the learners to determine the output of a program segment represented by the flowchart below. So they show us the flowchart. Copy and paste and complete the trace table below to determine what the output of the program segment will be. Right, so let's look at this thing. So we start the program, they give A 1. So A starts with 1. Oh wait, let's just also do this thing again. Well then, let's just put them center. Okay, so A starts at 1. Then we go down. And is A greater than 3? Is A greater than 3? Is 1 greater than 3? So you can go false. In this case, I just want to show you. So if you carry on like with trace table 1, we use true and false, which is 100% correct. You can also go just no if you want to. Is A greater than 3? A is not greater than 3, so no, it's not. So because it's no, we go down. Then they say B must get a value of 1. So B will give a value of 1. And A string must be blank. So A string is just blank. So you can just leave it blank. Then we go down. Is B greater than A? Is B greater than A? And that's no, because they are equal to each other. Then A string must become whatever A string was plus a star. So A string, remember here it was blank. So here, so it's going to get its first star inside. Then we go down and B becomes whatever B was plus 1. So B is going to become 2. Then we go back there. Is B greater than A? Is B greater than A? So now it's yes, it is. So we go back, display A string. So we're displaying the star. And we go back and A becomes A plus 1. So it becomes 2. And we go back. Then they say, is A greater than 3? A is not greater than 3. So no, it's not. Okay, let's just put the 2 there. You can go in there, but because that's already been completed, it might just look confusing. So it's better to leave that open and to rather just go there. So then it is not greater, so we go down. Then B become 1, so B is 1. A string is blank, so this is blank. Then is B greater than A? Is B greater than A? So the answer is no, it's not. Then A string become whatever A string was plus a star. So A string gets a star. There, then B becomes B plus 1, so B becomes 2. Go back. Is B greater than A? Is B greater than A? No, they're not. They are equal to each other. So no, so we add another star. So see, A string becomes whatever A string was plus a star. So now it's star star. B becomes B plus 1, so now it becomes 3. Is it greater? Yes, it is. Because it is, we display A string. So we display our 2 stars. We go back. A becomes A plus 1. So A is going to become 3. Is A greater than 3? No, it's not. They're equal to each other. So B becomes 1. A string becomes empty. Is B greater than A? B greater than A? No, it's not. We must add a star. We must make B one more. And then they ask, is B greater than A? No, it's not. We must add a star. B becomes one more. Is B greater than A? No, it's not. We must add a star. B becomes one more. We check, is B greater than A? Yes, it is. Because it is, we must display A string, so we display 3 stars. A becomes A plus 1, so A becomes 4. Is A greater than 3? Yes, it is. And we end our program. And that's our algorithm for trace table 2. Please tell me, how's it going? Any questions? Hello, Annika, you joined us.
Hello, sir. Sorry I was late. I just got caught up with something.
No, cool. No problem. We are recording the lesson as well, so it's fine.
Okay, thank you.
No problem. Okay, so any questions on this one?
No, sir. Thank you.
Okay, all good. So you got 2 goods. You need one more good?
It could.
I see. Alright. Now we can go to the third one. So let's go to the third one. Okay, they say the algorithm below is used to test the validity of a PIN code. So copy and paste the answer book and complete it to determine the output value if 623 is entered as the PIN value. So they already gave us the first three lines. So let's see. Line 1, input PIN, so that's that. Line 2, C gets a value of 0, so that's given to us. X gets the value of PIN, which is there. Then now we have to repeat. X gets the value of X divided by 10. So X is going to get the value if X is divided by 10. So what is this number divided by 10? 62.3. Okay. And C is going to get the value of C plus 1. So it's going to get a value of 1. And this must carry on until X is less than 1. So is X less than 1? No, it's not. No, it's not. So that means we carry on. That means we go back. X gets the value of X divided by 10. So it becomes 6.23. C is C plus 1. Becomes 2. Is X less than 1? No, it's not. So we divide this by 10 again. So it's 0.623. C is C plus 1, which is 3. Is X less than 1? Yes, it is. Okay, now we see. Then, if C is not equal to 5. Now, C is 5. So, it is. So, if C is not equal to 5, display error in PIN. So, this one's going to display error in PIN. Error in PIN. And that's it. That's all that was expected from this one. So, if I remember correctly, I could have actually added the other question. The next question could be... is C not equal to 5? And we set this yes. Because C is not equal to 5, because C is 3. So, with this one, quickly tell me... A second question on this could be, what is the requirement of a PIN then? What do they actually want from a PIN so that it will say the PIN is accepted? What is the requirement for this PIN?
It needs to be 5 digits.
It needs to be 5 digits. If it is 6 digits, will it work?
No.
No, it won't. Okay, this one must be exactly 5 digits to work. That's the requirement for this program. Alright, any questions on this trace table? I think it was relatively easy, this one.
All good, sir.
That's one all good.
All good.
Two all goods. Go, one more all good. Okay, one more all good. Okay, let's go. Okay, trace table 4. So also just so that we sort of on par, these ones that I've showed you, this one and that one and the first one we've done, it's all grade 12 papers I'm taking it from. So, yeah, it is what it is. So the question is, caps in the display, will we lose marks if our answer is not in caps? So this one is in the theory paper. So with the theory paper, we don't care about the capital letters and stuff. But even in the prac paper, we don't worry too much about case sensitivity. If we ask you to display a message where the whole message is in caps and you do it in small letters, it should be fine. So no, messages, if you do it small letters or capital letters, it's not a big issue. So don't worry about that. Okay, well this one, they didn't actually ask the trace table in this question. But I just also thought to do that, because what they asked us here is they asked, what is the value of S out before the loop has been executed? How many times will the loop be repeated? And what will the value of K when the variable N reaches the value of 1? So we can sort of answer these questions by doing a trace table. If you got these questions, obviously you won't do a trace table while you're answering this. Or you can, if you've got time, then you can do that. But the whole idea is you must actually just trace it in your mind. You must do a trace table, but either in your mind or you can do it on paper. It might be, if you've got time for a question like this to do it on paper, it might be better to do that. Okay, but so what I've done, I created our three variables and the display. So let's see, first line they said k must get a value of 2, so we give k a value of 2. Then they say s out must become the into string of k. So s out gets the value of k, which is 2. Okay, let's just do this again. Alright, then our for loop n starts at 0, so n starts at 0. And then k becomes whatever k was times 2. So k becomes whatever k was times 2, so 2 times 2 is 4. Then our, let's do this one separated, because we wanted to know what happens before the loop and. So let's quickly see. Okay, so k is 2. And then we put giving 2 to s out. Then n becomes 0. Let's do that lines one as well. So this is line 5, this is line 6, this was line 8. Then in line 10, k becomes k times 2, so k becomes 4. Then s out becomes, so this is line 11, s out becomes whatever s out was, which is 2, plus a comma, plus k, which is 4 now. Okay, then our for loop goes back, so then we go back to line 10. No, to line 8. Line 8, n becomes 1 more, so n is 1. Then line 10, k becomes k times 2, so 4 times 2 is 8. Then line 11, s out becomes whatever s out was, so it was a 2 comma 4. Then we must add okay, that's what it was. Then we must add a comma and a space and k again, which is now 8. Okay, then we go back to our line 8. N becomes 2, and then our line 10, k becomes k times 2, so it's 16. Then line 11, s out becomes whatever s out was, it was a 2 comma 4 8, and we must add a comma and a space and then 16. Then we go back to line 8, k becomes 3, then in line 10, k becomes k times 2, so it's 32, then s out becomes what, so in line 11, s out becomes whatever s out was, plus a comma and a space and what it's now. Then we go back to 8, our n increases to 4 now, then we go back to line 10, k becomes k times 2, so it becomes 64, and line 11 becomes whatever it was with a comma and a space and then 64. Okay, then what happens with, remember with a for loop, you actually go back to line 8, n will actually become 5, but because n is 5 now, the loop is done. So then it jumps out, then we'll jump to line 14, and then we'll display. Then we'll display that one. So if we wanted to do a trace table for this one, this is what it would have looked like. Okay, then let's quickly see, what is the value of s out before the loop has been executed? So the loops before the loop has been executed. So what is the value of s out before the loop has been executed? And we can see s out was 2. Then how many times will the loop be repeated? So you can see the loop is done, that's inside the loop. Once, twice, three, four, five times the loop will be executed or will be repeated. And then what will the value k, what will be the value of k when the variable n reaches the value of 1? So n reaches 1 here. So what is k's value at this stage? N reaches the value of k. So at this stage, when n reaches 1, what value does k have at this stage? Who wants to try for us? At this stage, what value does k have?
4.
Yeah, 100% correct. Because basically what happens, this number is actually there the whole time. This number is there the whole time. And that number is there the whole time. So an S out will have that value the whole time. Until that happens, then S out will be that the whole time. So that's sort of how it looks up until there. Because the variable will keep its value until you change it. So those values stay there the whole time. Alright, and that is 4 trace tables that I could find today that I quickly done. I will see if I can get some more to upload for you tomorrow if you want. But with the trace tables itself, all of you good? Any good? Oh, it went and changed the numbers. Okay, but all of you have got the idea. Let's just... it went and messed up all those ones. Okay, any questions on trace tables?
No, sir.
So if the question, okay, we're already,
yeah,
yes, Cozy. Oh, you said no. Okay, well, people, that's sort of it for today. That's all I wanted to do. Let me just quickly stop.